For this video, we talk about how we can use the information from our integrated rate laws to determine the order of a reaction. So remember in our last video, we described the equation we use for a first order linear plot and the equation we use for a second order plot. In this one, we talk about how we can generate graphs and then determine what order a reaction is. So we can plot or we can measure concentrations of reactants over time. We can take various functions of those concentrations, just concentration, natural log, or inverse of concentration. We can plot each one versus time. The one that gives us the most linear graph determines the order. So if concentration versus time is linear, that's a zero order reaction. If natural log of concentration versus time is linear, that's first order. And if one over concentration versus time is linear, it's a second order reaction. For our example, we're going to look at this reaction, decomposition of 2NO2. So again, we first measure concentrations of NO2 at various time intervals. So we'll plot concentration versus time for one graph. For our second graph, we then take the natural log of each concentration value to get this one. We'll plot those values versus time. And then we take the inverse of each concentration value to get our third column. We'll plot those values versus time to get our third graph. So our first graph, we have here plotted concentration versus time. Notice that it's downward sloping, but our dots do not follow a straight line. So I think it's safe to say that this is not zero order. Here, we've taken the natural log of each concentration value and plotted versus time. Our data points are a bit more linear, so could be first order, but to ensure, we want to compare to second order to see which is most linear. So here we've plotted the inverse of concentration versus time. Notice when we do that, our data points are in a perfect linear plot, upward sloping because of the positive slope in that equation. And so we can now verify that that reaction is second order overall. And so this is how we can use graphs to determine the order of a reaction.